This video will show how to set up Mwago's new IP65 Industrial Wireless Ethernet Gateway. This product can work as either an access point or a client using Bluetooth 4.0 or 802.11. Because this product is IP65 rated, it uses a M12 connection for the Ethernet and the power, so you'll need special cables for that, as well as an adapter to get that back to a RJ45 connection for your Ethernet. For the 24 volts DC, we're using lever nuts. You could also use terminal blocks. And then for our power, we're using a Mwago 24 volts DC power supply. We'll start by connecting the M12 connections for Ethernet and power, as well as the adapter to the RJ45 cable. Brown and white are your 24 volts signal, and your blue and black is your common. Go ahead and connect those using lever nuts to our power supply, and then we'll be ready to plug in power and start up the device. There's a very easy way to set the device back to factory defaults. If you consult the manual, there's a whole section on performing the procedure, and I'm going to walk you through it here. Down on section 7.3.2, you can see if you turn the device on and then hold the mode button for 10 seconds, that will set the device back to its factory default. The factory default IP address is 192.168.0.99, so now we can get to it with our computer. I'll change my computer's IP address to be on that subnet, and now I can access the web-based management using the web browser. We'll change this to 192.168.4.99 with my router at 4.1. Now I can set my laptop back to DHCP and access the web-based management at the new IP address. I'll change the operating mode from client to access point and change the SSID to Mwago and enter a passkey here, then just click save and reboot. So let's take a quick look at the other settings. On Easy Config, you can optimize the device for certain networking configurations as shown here. Under the Bluetooth settings menu, you can configure the device to be either a client or an access point using the Bluetooth spectrum. It also shows you which devices have been paired. In this case, I'm just using standard wireless LAN, so I'm going to skip that. There's also abilities to do firmware update, issue AT commands, and perform a factory default as well through the web interface. So now we can test the access point. We'll go ahead and unplug the laptop's wired Ethernet cable, and if we browse wireless networks, we can see the Mwago access point. I enter the password and click join, and now we can just make sure that the internet works and that we can browse the network. So as you can see, this is a really easy way to set up an industrial access point using Mwago's Ethernet gateway. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you.